My name is James Taylor. I am Professor of Voice at the Institute of Sacred Music in Yale University. I run the program here in Early Music, Oratorio, and Art Song. And I think our program is very unique in the United States in that we don't really concentrate on opera as most sort of classically oriented voice programs in the United States do. We concentrate on the concert repertoire and are basically centered in Baroque music, Bach and Handel being very, very important to the program. But we go in both directions from there and delve into the medieval and also the contemporary. I find this very, very important when working with the students because I think in today's market, it pays to be very flexible. And I think if you can sing Hildegard von Bingen chants and you can sing Strauss Art Song, then you have a better chance of making it in this very competitive world today. People may wonder why the Institute of Sacred Music even has a voice program. I don't think it's particularly commonplace that a place like the Institute have a voice program and where students receive a degree in voice. But for me, it's quite logical. My students sing sacred repertoire, sacred texts. They are telling a story often when they're singing oratorios. They are telling stories from the Old Testament, from the New Testament. They function as kind of a minister, a priest, if you will. And they need to know what it is they're talking about. They need to understand the context of what it is they're talking about. They need to understand the history of what it is they're saying. They need to understand the characters in the drama that they're portraying. And I can think of no better place than the Institute for that to take place. Our faculty is diverse. We work regularly with our art historians, with our theologians. We have literature experts. It's a remarkable place, and this is really unusual for a conservatory-type atmosphere, and the students benefit greatly from being in the presence of these scholars on a weekly basis. Oftentimes, when students are applying for the program here at the Institute of Sacred Music, they ask me what it is that my students go on to do after they graduate. That's a great question. Because of the flexibility that's built into our program, my students do a wide variety of things. So there's not really one path that any one student takes. I have students that sing in medieval ensembles, Renaissance groups. I have students that do contemporary music. I have a number of students in the ensemble Room Full of Teeth, for example. Kaleidoscope is a group that comes to mind. These students travel throughout the United States. They sing in a variety of choruses where they act as choir members and also soloists. I have students that have followed more of the traditional oratorio path and they sing Handel and Bach around the country. But I've had students also in big opera programs like the Lindemann program at the Met. Students that are living in Europe and singing opera in Europe as well. So really, you name it, and my students are doing it. There's a lot of students concentrating on electronic music, some modern sorts of music, popular styles. This makes me very proud because I just want my students to go out there, enjoy their lives, be singers, make money doing what it is that they love, and I think I can safely say that upwards of 80%, maybe even as many as 90% of my class make their living performing vocal music.